like get a little note about recording, so you can just say okay with us.
I have a question.
Yes.
Just lately, we started to have a caption of your talk, and it doesn't help, and it covers part of you. Do you know about it?
No. So right now you see caption?
Yes. Everything you tell me, I see. But the thing is that it covers part of you, and you speak English well. We don't need it.
Well, I can see if I can turn it off for my class. Probably not right now because it's gonna take some time, but
Okay.
after class I can look into it, okay? Because I don't know exactly where to change it and if I can change it. It should be probably changeable. All right. Yeah, so get everyone muted now. Someone, okay, good. There we go. So I'm gonna mute you, Chris, okay? Mary, mute. Start it. All right, so we don't really start in a chair, but you can also stand. Just a bit of stretching. Just a nice deep breath, feeling your posture, feeling your spine nice and tall, shoulders relaxed. And then begin with your breath. Release belly so you can take that full breath in. Nice deep breath in and out. All right. And then bringing the arms up and overhead, big stretch up. And then exhale, forward fold. All the way down if you can. And then inhale up and overhead again. And exhale, forward fold. And breathe in. And breathe out one more time. Good. And back up to seated. And then we'll do some side bends. Side to side, up and over. Feel that stretch in the side body. Great. And then some shoulder circles. And then let's do the opposite arm and legs. Leg straight forward, arm up and overhead. Reach through the fingertips. If you're standing, then you could perhaps do just a little lower if you can. But if you're seated, try to get that leg a bit parallel to the floor. So you're really firing up this quadricep muscles. Perfect. And then let's do okay, so either seated, do this ankle circles, or yeah, you could hold on to something, do it like this. Or keep your fingers, toes down and just move your heel in circles. Good. Other side. Nice job. Big circles. Perfect. Great. And then we're gonna go for a little bit of core for warm up. So if you're standing, you can do the same. So opposite elbow, twisting towards that knee. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, and 20. Perfect. Okay. And let's do a few stand-ups. So coming up and down into a chair or doing squats. So if you're doing squats, go down and back with the hips, but keep looking straight forward. Don't look down. Your back is extended. All right, so all the way to the chair and up, or squats. Nice big opening with the arms. Perfect. Good. All right. Let's put in some music. We're going to stand up. Oh, no, 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 no. Stop it. All right. Coming for some time. When it's over, so they say, it'll rain a sunny day. I know. All right, start marching. Like water. Nice high knees. I won't know. And move those arms. Marching, and then bring the arms in and straighten them up. Open the fingers too as you reach out. Sun is cold and rain is hot. I know. Been that way for all my time. Really straighten those elbows as much as you can. And then up. Go down, so you're gonna bend the knees and go down, kind of like you want to touch the shin, and then up and down and up down. So drive those hips back, bending the knees, keep the spine nice and long. Look forward. Good. All right. And then straighten up. Gonna twist and reach across. Big reach, big stretch. Cross the hips. And then slap on the side. And when the man waves hail to the chief, ooh, they point the cannon at you now. It ain't me, it ain't me. Right, take the hips with you as you twist. It ain't me.
Some folks are born silver spooning.
do some swimming. Who's watching the Olympics? I've only watched gymnastics. This is amazing. Good. Good. And then let's go for the heel up towards the butt. You shift the weight. Lift that heel as high as you can. Pointing the knees down. Perfect. Good. And then nice wide stand. And we're gonna go side to side. Bending one, straightening the other. Good. And then cross the arms. Lift up. Lift. You can go a little lower here. Up. Down. And up. Perfect, good. And then let's go up on the opposite leg, maybe knee or shin, or even lower. Okay, come down, Lee, yeah, down for the shin, good. Perfect. Good. And then arms out to the side, thumbs up. And then do the circle. Good. And reach across for the opposite shoulder. Wiggle side to side a bit. Hey, nice. And then let's kick. So you could hold on if you want or not. Kick. A nice, quick, dynamic motion. Yeah, kick straight forward. Kick straight forward. Yeah, that's it. Good. Perfect. And then do one more for the hips in a big circle. So soften your knees. They're not locked. And then draw a big circle of your pelvis. Loosen it up. And reverse. Waking for the man every night and day. And I never lost a minute of sleep. Great. Okay, and then we'll try stepping forward to the right leg. So you're in a split stance, right? And then imagine you're kayaking. So you're going to dip on one side, dip on the other side. Go down the river. Feel that twist, right? So you're twisting to the right, twisting to the left. But I never saw the good side of a city till I hit the ride on a riverboat queen. Big wheel, keep on painting. Good. And then switch legs. Other leg forward. Same thing. Rolling, 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 rolling. And really twist. You feel it around here. Good. Perfect. Good. Nice. Then we'll try that step forward with a power up to land and bend the knee. Nice big step. Perfect. Good. And walk it out. And let's do the quicker opening, closing of the fingers. Really open. Straighten them. And then let's move our flappers. And lift, squeeze and lift. Yes, elbows up, elbows down to your ribs, right? Yeah. Up, down, without lifting the shoulders. So shoulders down, just moving. Good. Good. And then let's swim with those elbows or box. So again, a little bit of rotation, right? You can try to go faster. Yes, it's driving that elbow forward, right? So the fist stays kind of in front of your chest. So rather than boxing, it's elbow boxing. Yeah. Good, 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 good. And then we'll go out, cross, out, cross, and then chop, 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 chop. Okay, and then out, cross, out, cross, chop, out, cross, out, cross, chop, chop, out, cross, out, cross, chop, 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 chop. Out, cross, out, cross, chop, 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 good, and then march. And then let's do a nice big step, or you could even hop, either big step. Reach, reach, reach. A little hop or step. Uh-oh, are we freezing again?
People say you hang from what you see.
Perfect. All right, so let's get ready for the dumbbells. And I'm gonna go over a few movements that are kinda new. I'm gonna stop the music for a while. Okay. So one newer movement will be sort of it's a bicep curl, but it's a little more complicated. So it's it has three portions of it. So first you're gonna go just halfway up, right? So 90 degrees. So up halfway, So your shins, sorry, your forearms are parallel to the floor, and then slowly lower down. Then you're going to go all the way up to your shoulders, and then you lower down halfway. Not all the way, but halfway, right? So you're holding. Good. And then you're going to go all the way up and all the way down. Okay, so let's do it again. So nice little posture. So halfway up, down, all the way up, halfway down, all the way up, all the way down. Halfway up, down, all the way up, halfway down, up and down. Okay, so a little bit complicated. That's what we want. We need to focus. It's not just a, like a simple movement. All right, and the next one. Gonna be a split stance. So you're gonna get one foot forward, and then you're gonna lower. So bend the knee, lower down, and it's gonna be just one arm. Okay, so one this arm, and then you're gonna go up, kind of like with the power, right? With the power of your hips. So down. And then push down into that foot to get that dumbbell up and down. And up. And then we'll switch halfway. Oh, actually, sorry. It was even more complicated what I wanted to do. So down, drive it up, and then lower it to the shoulder and lower. Okay, so again, down, drive it up and overhead, straight arm. Lower down to your shoulder and then lower down. Okay. And then the last one will be in a hinge. It's for the triceps, right? The back of the arm. So you're going to go extend one arm behind you. See, I'm not having the arm here, but here, right? So it's the hard part that to hold those elbows back. So one arm, other arm. And then you're gonna go one, two, three, four. Okay, slower, slower, pushing back. So one, back, two, back, and then one, two, three, four. All right. Yeah, there's gonna be a reverse, but the second one is reverse fly. So for that, you also hinge forward. I'm not rounding, right? I'm keeping the spine extended, chest up. And then you do this, right? So you push up the elbows up and then squeeze them down. So push up towards the ceiling as you're bending forward. Lee, can you bend forward a little bit? Yeah. So my chest is actually sort of pointing down. So the more you can do down, the harder it's gonna be, right? Because you're fighting gravity. It really strengthens the back. In the back of your arms. Okay. Side squat, overhead press. Yeah, so we'll do the first one will be okay. We're gonna go squat and then one arm up, one arm side, and then down first side. Down, one arm up, one arm to the side. All right, let's give it a try. So we'll have 10 dumbbells, and then five, the last five will be sort of more aerobic. So we'll do just either jogging, or you can do like high knees or something that gets your heart rate up, right? So really moving pretty fast. So that's gonna be the last five. Okay, so let's do this. 15 exercises. Oh yeah, we need some music, right? Oh, come on. There we go. All right. All right, so let's get ready for that squat and then arm up, one arm to the side. Ready, set, go. Bam. And push it. Okay, breathing. Core engaged. Down and up. 15 more seconds. 5. Last one. Good. All right. Second one's the reverse fly. So you're really hinging forward and then moving your wings out to the side, right? So keep the core engaged. Go for it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That's it. 6. Feel it in the back. 7. Yeah, lean forward a little bit. Yeah, stick your butt out and lean forward. You can take a break if that's too much. 50 more seconds. Get those that back strong. Good, and rest. So now we are doing the curl. Halfway up, down, all the way up, halfway down, all the way up, all the way down. Down, up, halfway down, up, all the way down. Halfway up, down, all the way up, halfway down, up, and down. Halfway up. All the way up. Halfway down. Halfway down. Halfway down. And all the way down. All right, and rest. Okay, so now we're gonna go lunging out into a squat, and then we come out, then go up, and then other side, squat, up, coming back to center, lunge out, squat, up. Down, up, down, up, step down, and last one. Good, and rest. So now we're gonna go hamstring curl, hamstring curl, punch, punch, curl, curl, punch, punch, curl, curl, punch, punch, curl, curl, punch, punch. Kick your butt, kick your butt. Punch, big punch. Three more seconds. Curl, curl, punch, punch. Curl, curl, punch, punch. And rest. Alicia. Round, round, get around, I get around. Yeah, we're gonna go down like that. And then so holding your dumbbells in front of you. Trying to be upright. Nice wide stance. Then, so you're driving the hips back a little bit as well. So you can get down into the, yeah, so you're driving the hips back. You're not going down straight, but back, right? Sideways and back. And rest. Okay, so this is sort of a power push. So again, overhead press, but we're gonna use the legs to get us into the momentum. So you're gonna go up, right? So you can even like hop a little. Kind of like you're a power lifter. Push it up.
I don't know what you do to me, to the booty, oh Rudy, to the booty, oh Rudy.
Yeah, you could jump switch, even, if that's okay for you. Nice. Oh, sure, you're supposed to rest. Still rest. Alright, next one is a hinge, row, and stand. So, rolling down your leg, hit a row. And stand up.
To the booty,
oh, hold forward, rolling down.
Booty,
oh, knees.
To the booty,
row.
Oh,
release.
To the booty,
stand
oh,
up.
To the booty,
roll down towards your knees.
Oh,
row.
Oh,
release.
Stand
up.
Me crazy.
Keep your back from rounding.
Knows how to love me, yes indeed. Boy, you don't know what you do to me, to the booty. Oh,
Rudy. Catching the hamstrings.
Oh, Rudy.
Perfect. And rest.
Oh, Rudy. To the booty. Oh, Rudy. To the booty. Oh, Rudy.
Okay, so now we're doing the split stance. You're gonna go down and drive it up. Lower, release. And drive it up. Okay. And drive it. Shoulder. Okay, one more time on the side. Good, and switch leg. Other side. So down. Drop. Shoulder. Good, and rest. And the last one is the triceps extension. Arm, other arm, and then one, two, three, four, both arms. And then bend again. So one, two, and one, two, three, four. One, two, one, two, three, four. One, two, really push back. One, two, three, four. Arm is behind you. One, two, one, two, three, four. One, two, last one. One, two, three, four. Good. Okay, so then I'm jogging or moving like that. What do you 25 seconds. You can put your dog. All right, ready, set, go. Go, 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 go. You can run, that's okay. I just do like a vigorous march. Or like a step touch, like that. In seconds. Don't go breaking my heart. I won't go breaking your heart. Almost there. Don't go breaking my heart. And right. Alright. We'll do it. Seconds. Excellent. And rest. All right, let's do one last one. You're hopping or marching or running. Or we could do like jumping. Go for it. You don't have to jump. You could lift your heels up really high. Excellent, everyone. Good job. Many more seconds. A celebration to last throughout the years. So bring your good times and your laughter too. We gon' celebrate your party with you. Come on. 5 seconds. And love jump. Good. All right. And the last one. We'll do this. The plank to down dog. You can do it on the floor. It's time. Plank. Down dog. It's up to you. Plank. Four work. Alright. Ready, set, go. Last exercise of the high intensity work. Keep that core engaged. Keeping your form, that nice straight plank. It's a celebration. Celebrate good times. Come on, let's celebrate. There's a party going on right here. 15 seconds. Excellent. We did it. Congrats. Let's grab some water. Hopefully you're a little bit sweaty. Good job, everyone.
It's a celebration.
Do a little dancing.
Let's celebrate. Come on now.
Let's go up with the arm. Touch the back of the head, or neck, rather.
Let's celebrate.
And then up with the other arm. And then both arms up and down.
Let's celebrate.
So bend.
It's
all right. Other arm. And extend and down. And one more. Always point that elbow up. Other arm.
Let's celebrate.
Extend.
It's all right.
And release. Good. And some more shoulder circles. And then let's try to like squeeze the shoulders and shoulder blades back, right? So you squeeze, which opens the collarbones. You hold it. Put the shoulders down so you're not up like that. Good. And release. Good. And then again, squeeze, open the chest. Hold those shoulder blades together. And release. Okay. Last one. Good. Let's do the circles with each finger. Just the thumbs. Circle the thumbs. And then the index fingers. Try to make a circle with them. Just the index finger and middle finger. And ring finger. And pinky. Good. And then interlace. And reach up if you can. Bit more of that side bend. Good, and then we'll go for a forward fold. So you can keep your knees slightly bent and go down as low as you can. Good, and then slowly up. Great. Let's go down on the mat. Turn off the music. Okay. So I'm gonna come onto all fours. You don't want to be on your knees. You could have your hands on the chair and stand. Okay, so you're on all fours. And we'll do like cow. So you're gonna round your back, look down at your knees, so flexing the neck as well. And exhale. And then drop the belly, lift the heart forward and the head on the inhale, and also lifting the tailbone up. And then rounding the back on the exhale. Keep your arms straight. You're not bending the elbows. Your arms straight. It's all movement of the spine and the pelvis. Let's just bring some fluidity into that back. Good. And then we'll go for child's pose. So you're bringing the hips back towards your knee, towards your heels, and then moving your arms forward. So you're nice. You get that nice stretch in the underarms as well.
Shoulders.
And then walk your hands from that child's pose, right? Walk your arms to the right so you're getting that nice stretch, side stretch. So stay in child's pose, just walk your arms to the side. So keep moving the butt back. So the hands are forward, right? And the butt moves back, and that produces that big stretch. And then walk your arms over to the other side for that side stretch. Perfect. Okay, and then we'll be pressed either on the floor, or if you don't want to be on the belly, you could do it on the wall, standing at the wall, hands shoulder width, about shoulder height. And then you're going to bring the chest forward, head and shoulders away, right? So you're getting that nice arching. Otherwise, your belly. If that's too hard, then a little bit in front of you. And then on the inhale, you're going to lift into baby cobra. So you're not lifting with your arms, right? You're not pushing yourself up. You're trying to really engage the upper back muscles to lift off the floor. Good. And then exhale. You can do inhale up, exhale down. Or hold it up for a bit. Really feel that engagement in the upper back. Breathe through it. And then exhale. Yeah, these exercises are hard, but very important for your posture. To keep strengthening the back. So do a few of those. Of course, if anything hurts, then you might have to adjust. Maybe try to also extend through the legs, and maybe even tuck your tailbone under just a tiny bit to create more space in the low back so you don't feel too much crunch in the low back. I kind of engage my glutes when I do this, which creates a little more space in the low back. And then you can lift from there. Okay, and then we'll just do the leg lift. So you can either rest your head on your forearms or just look slightly forward. And then you're lifting one leg at a time straight though. So a lot of people, what happens is that they bend. And oftentimes it's because their quads are tight. So try to really think about straightening that leg, lengthening through the toes and lifting up. So you will feel it in the low back. It strengthens the low back and the glutes and the hamstrings. But hopefully you'll feel just that engagement of the muscles, not pain. Keep lifting that thigh off the floor a little bit. And possibly not too jerky movements, right? Like you don't want to do something to your back. So see if you can do it smoothly up with the inhale And smoothly down with the exhale. Good. All right, and if you've done a few, you can roll over onto your back and just hug your knees into your chest, rock side to side. Great. And then let's bring the arms out to the side. Feet are down, knees together, bent. And then you go, you keep your shoulders down and head, and then you move your knees side. Always get a little crack in my spine. Chiropractic adjustment. Good, that's it. Perfect. And then just let's see, let's bring the arms up and overhead. See if you can touch the floor. See if at least your thumbs can touch. Using the gravity to help you stretch the shoulder. Good. And last one maybe before we do Shavasana, straight butterfly pose. So keep your knees and feet together and then open the knees to the side. Right, so for a butterfly, it's kind of hard to see, but like this, right? Feet together, knees apart, you're lying down. You're lying down, and just opening the knees to the side. Stretching the groins, inner thighs. Great, great, great. Couple more breaths, and then we can just find a comfortable position, lying down, and do a relaxation. So, no effort needed. You could be just flat, or have a pillow under your knees, or maybe even put your legs up on your couch like this, or chair. It feels pretty good. So just find a position that feels supportive, relaxing. Turn your attention within, and turn your attention to the sensation you currently feel in your body without judgment. Just noticing with curiosity, you feel any, you know, warmth or tingling anywhere, or maybe you feel a little tired. You might also feel the endorphins circling in your body right now after exercise. You feel good hormones, or maybe your mood is elevated and you feel proud and accomplished. For showing up and doing the exercise, doing the hard work for your health. Feel a little gratitude for your body too. for all the wonderful things it's doing for you every day. Even if it causes you trouble sometimes, it still does a lot of good work. And then notice your breath. See if you can take some deep belly breaths. Belly rising on the inhale and falling on the exhale. And then maybe set an intention for the day, depending on what you're working with. You know, maybe it could be just like you're gonna have fun, or you're gonna be less anxious or less, you know, but stated in a positive. So stated like, I'm gonna be positive today. Or I'm gonna meet some friends today. Something positive. And then slowly start moving your fingers and toes. Maybe take a stretch. And when you're ready, you can roll over to your side, come up to sitting. Great job, everyone. I like to close the class with this little intentions or loving kindness wish for ourselves. So feel free to join me. May I be happy. May I be healthy. May I be mindful. May I have courage. May I have fun, and may I treat myself and others with love and compassion. And the hands to your forehead as a reminder of the power of your thoughts. Hands to your lips, the reminder of the power of your words. And hands to your heart, the reminder of the power of your actions. Good job. Give yourself a clap. And then you might have gotten the email about my Friday class and reminding everyone, if you're around Oakland, I know some of you live very far, so I don't expect you to come, but if you're around Oakland, I teach a class at the North Oakland Senior Center on Fridays at 9:30. It's called Brain Fit Cardio. It's a little similar to this, but we also do some in-person stuff, and we're going to have a photographer there this Friday to make pictures and promote the class. So if anyone can come, it'd be great to have you. But if you don't want to be photographed, that's fine too. And just come either we can put a sticker on you and the photographer won't take a picture, or you can come another time.
Thank you for class.
Thank you. Thank you. Good job. All right. I'll see you guys. Oh yeah.
Thank you. Very
good. Recording.